Good morning, children. Today, we shall learn the first chapter in economics of class 11th, that is economics and introduction. A human is an intellectual animal. His aim is to live life peacefully and happily. As I said before, a human is an intellectual animal. His aim is to live life peacefully and happily. For this, he studies conditions surrounding him, analyzes it, and always tries to find the proper and appropriate way. In human life, he engages himself in economic, social, political, and religious activities. Economic activity is the central activity in human life. To satisfy human wants of goods and services, he needs to earn income and spend it on various activities known as economic activity. In short, economics deals with the solution of economic problems and economic behavior of human being. Economics deals with the problems which arises while doing economic activity and solves the problem intellectually and logically. To find the solution of economic problems, it is necessary to know the scope of economics. To get this, it is necessary to collect various statistical information and analysis of it. In this chapter, we will study about evolution and development of economics and how to present statistical information through diagrams and graphs. Let us now understand the meaning of economics. In Indian economic thought, economics means Arthashastra, which is derived from the Sanskrit word Arth. Earth means purpose or to seek benefits. So in Sanskrit, Arthashastra means science of earth. The English word economics is derived from the Greek word oikonomos. Oikos means households and nomos means management, and hence economics means management of households. Our next topic is economics in Indian thought. In Indian thought, the four purposes of human being are dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. The activities of life done for earth are the subject matter of economics. Kautilya, in his book Arthashastra, discussed economics as economic activity undertaken by a state or society for creating earth. In Indian thought, intention of economic activities do not remain only for creating earth, but are done considering human welfare. So Kautilya called economics as ethics. Philosophy of Eastern economics differs from philosophy of Western economics. Kautilya contributes more in the philosophy of Eastern economics, while Aristotle contributes more in the philosophy of Western economics many years before. Aristotle, he gave his views on economics in his book Oi Economia. With advent of industrial revolution due to specialization, many changes occurred in the study of human behavior and economics developed as an independent science. Let us now understand the definition of economics presented by various economists. The first is Adam Smith. The first ever effort to define the scope of Western economics was made by Adam Smith in his book, An Enquiry into the Nature and Causes of Wealth of Nations, or the short name of The Wealth of Nations. According to Adam Smith, economics is the science which studies the activities connected with production, consumption, and exchange of material wealth. According to Adam Smith, economics is the study of the nature and causes of the wealth of nations. He introduced economics as a social science. The next is Alfred Marshall. In his book Principles of Economics, published in 1890, Alfred Marshall defines economics as the study of mankind in the ordinary business of life. According to him, economics keeps human well-being at the center of human activity and explains how well-being is attained from material consumption. We shall now see the definition of economics given by Lionel Robbins. In 1931, Lionel Robbins, in his book Nature and Significance of Economics, defines economics as a science which studies human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means which have alternative uses. Resources satisfying human wants are limited and have alternative uses. Hence, economics deals with the problems of allocation of scarce resources to satisfy the human wants to the maximum possible extent. According to him, economics does not deal with norms, and thus it is not a normative science, but it is a positive science. Paul Samuelson, in his book Foundations of Economic Analysis, published in 1947, defines economics as the study of how people and society end up choosing with or without the use of money to employ scarce productive resources that could have alternative uses to produce various commodities over time and distributing them for consumption now or in the future among various persons in the society. It analyzes costs and benefits of improving patterns of resource allocation. Hence, Samuelson talks about choice, allocation of scarce resources, and evaluation of costs and benefits of doing so. All the definitions, in a way, commonly point out that economics deals with and studies human behavior. And it is positive in nature, adopts scientific methods and methodologies, and thus it is a social science. Now let us understand the definition of economic and non-economic activity, which has already been explained in Chapter 1 of OC. Most human beings perform several activities during a day. They meet friends, spend time in shops, engage in political discussions, watch televisions and films, and do much more. But all activities are not the subject matter of economics. Economics studies only economic activities. Let us see the meaning of economic activity. Any activity performed with the purpose of getting economic benefits in the form of incomes involving exchange of goods and services and factors as well as involving costs is called economic activity. Important aspects about economic activity pertain to purpose of making economic gains, satisfaction of wants, and involvement of exchange and cost. The examples of economic activity are eating in a restaurant and incurring expense, watching a movie in a theater, incur expense to get entertainment, work in one's own farm to exert labor and get output, get employed in a school to teach and get a salary. Thus, human requirements are plenty. Activity for fulfillment of a requirement through a transaction which involves costs and benefits on both sides is called economic activity. Farmers, lawyers, teachers, actors, government all perform economic activity. The following chain of activity is another example to clarify the meaning of economic activity. A farmer needs a motorcycle. In order to earn income to pay for the motorcycle, she works in a farm and sells the output for money. The seller of motorcycle, who earns money by selling the motorcycle, spends it to fulfill some other wants. Meaning of non-economic activity. Any activity which is performed without the specific purpose of obtaining economic gains is non-economic activity. It does not involve exchange of benefits on both sides of the transaction. It is done for love, respect, honor. These activities involve costs, but these costs are not incurred to get monetary economic benefits in exchange. The following definitions of economic activity and non-economic activity are already discussed in OC Chapter 1. You can write the same if you find that easy. We shall deal with the branches of economics, micro and macroeconomics, in the next lecture. Until then, goodbye, take care.